So we are discussing about the five kingdom classification, and the first is bacteria group Monera. We already finished Monera, that is the first kingdom. Second kingdom is fungi. Second kingdom is protista, which also we finished. Protista group, protista also we finished. Third group is fungi. Today we are going to discuss about fungi, and the fourth is plant kingdom. Fifth is animal kingdom. So Monera, bacteria group we finished. Protista, protozoans, so many different type of protozoan we explained. Today we are going to discuss about fungi. So fungi, so many examples are familiar to you. Last year you studied about rhizopus or bread mold, which is growing on the bread, and you are very familiar with the another one is yeast. Rhizopus, you are familiar. Rhizopus, very familiar fungus, and yeast, which is used for making bread and other things. And the third one is very common one is mushroom, which is edible, and mushrooms are there. Kuna, then penicillium, another important fungus which is used for making antibiotics, penicillin antibiotic. These are very useful fungi. Many of them are, some of them are yeast and mushroom and penicillium, they are useful. Rhizopus is not useful. So these are some common types of fungi, and these fungi, they have some common characteristic is this, they are filamentous. If you examine this fungi group, they are living on different decomposing materials, or as they are living as parasite, and inside the body they will be filamentous tubular structures. Some may be branched, or some may not be branched. You can see they are tubular structured, and some fungi, these tubules have no cross wall, no walls will be in between, and some will have walls. So you can see walls will be there, some will have walls, and some have no cross wall. This is cross wall. Some fungi have no cross wall, some have cross wall. If there is no cross wall, it is just tubular. No cross wall means just it will be tubular like this. These tubular structures is called hypha, plural hypha, called hypha. Hypha is plural. And a mass of hypha we call mycelium. A part is called hypha, a group of hypha together we call mycelium. It's called mycelium. So what is mycelium? The group of hypha, a mass of hypha is called mycelium. So the hypha can be tubular or with the cross walls. If they are having no cross wall, you can see many nuclei. Here you can see nucleus will be there. Nucleus will be there. But if they are having many, no cross wall, many nuclei will be inside. So many nuclei, because it is made up of many cells, but no cross wall. If there are many nuclei like this inside, there is a name for this condition. It is called a cenocytic condition. Cenocytic condition. Cenocytic condition means condition in which many nuclei are seen together. Cenocytic condition. Cenocyte. So what are cenocyte means? The one with a cell with many nuclei are called cenocytic condition. You can see, you already studied that some fungi, they form association with algae, and very common one, lichens. You studied Lichen means it is an association of algae and fungi, and it is a symbiotic association. Symbiotic association means both organisms are benefited because of this association. And here these lichens contain algae. Algae is photosynthetic, meaning green colored and photosynthetic. They manufacture food, and then fungi provide protection and provide raw materials for food production. Everything will be given by the fungi. And so both are living together and helping each other. And this kind of association is called symbiotic association. And also in higher plants like cycas, you know, the roots of these plant cycas and some higher plants, you can see inside the root some fungi are living. And this kind of roots are called mycorrhizal. They are called mycorrhizal association. This mycorrhiza is also an example of symbiosis. Is also an example of symbiosis. Lichens and mycorrhiza both are symbiotic, and this is some basic things about fungi. Now we are going to the type of reproduction. Many fungi, they are reproduced asexually and sexually. Two type of reproductions are there. So asexual reproduction without the fusion of sex cells, and sexual reproduction also is here. Sexual reproduction also is here. Asexual and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, different type of spores are produced. Spore, dust-like structure, spore. It can be easily carried out by wind, and you studied in last year Rhizopus. Bread mold, spores are produced in the sporangium. Last year test diagram also is there. And we are going to see this one. And some produce, and most of them are also having sexual reproduction, not all. Sexual reproduction also is there. In a sexual reproduction, you can see two hyphae of a two fungus, two different strain, one hypha. So this is a sexual reproduction. Another hypha of another fungus, and for example like this. This is one fungus, this is another fungus. And this is sexual reproduction. Both the same type of fungus, maybe different strain. Strain means different organism, that is all, different type. Or it can be same type also. And when they come together, they meet each other. Two hypha will meet each other. And this wall will decompose, or it will be dissolved. And these two nuclei, it will come together. So two nuclei will come together. So this first stage, you can see there is a fusion of cytoplasm. And that is actually called plasmogamy. And after the plasmogamy, you can see the protoplasm of two hyphae joined together, two nuclei are here. And after this one, these nucleus both will combine, and both the nucleus will combine, and it will become a single nucleus. And here you have to understand one important thing. We are diploid, meaning if you examine any cell from our body, we have 46 chromosomes, that is diploid state. But our gametes, male gamete and female gamete, that is a sperm and egg, only 23 chromosomes. But all fungi, the body, body of the fungi or mycelium is haploid, meaning half the number of chromosomes. So the nucleus that is produced here, it is actually because of the fusion of two nucleus. So now this will become diploid. Diploid means double the number of chromosomes. But the original hypha contain only haploid number. So now it has become diploid. So before this will become a going to become a another Haifa. Before that one, next stage is a special type of division which you studied last year again is called meiosis will take place. What is the aim of meiosis? The chromosome will become half. Total number of chromosome will become half. It will become again haploid. And after the formation of the haploid phase, and the fusion of this nucleus is called karyogamy. Fusion of protoplasm is called plasmogamy. And the next stage is the diploid nucleus form. It will undergo meiosis, and again it will become haploid. And so this is about the sexual reproduction in plants. Some cases you can see two nucleus, when they come together, they will remain close to each other for long time. It will remain like that, two nuclei without fusion. And this phase, you know, orimichirikkunna ee samayathinu parayunna perana, it is called a dikaryon phase, and that is a characteristic of some fungi. So there are different types of asexual and sexual reproduction in fungi, and we are going to divide fungi into some groups. And the first group is called phycomycetes. The first group of fungi is phycomycetes. Four groups are there. Phycomycetes fungi. In phycomycetes, if you examine phycomycetes fungi, many of them are aquatic, meaning they are living in the water, and some are living in a decaying wood, and even some are living in a bread. That is a Rhizopus example is coming under this group. Rhizopus is an example. It is growing on decaying wood, and even damp places, that is irpulla salathum, they can grow. And even some of them are parasite. They can cause some of them can be parasite. The mycelium is aseptate, meaning no crossover. Mycelium is tubular, no crossovers are there. So once again, what are the characteristics of this group? Once again, they are mainly aquatic, or they grow on decaying wood. They can grow in damp places, and also they can be parasitic also. Some of them are parasitic, and the mycelium is aseptate, and this condition many nuclei are there, and it is called a cenocytic condition is found. Asexual reproduction by spores. Our example very common one is Rhizopus bread mold. And asexual reproduction you studied last year. This is the bread. You can see, and you can see it is growing inside. It's tubular. And some of the hyphae, it will grow into the atmosphere. And the tip of the atmosphere, the tip of this hyphae in the atmosphere, they will become enlarged and a bulb shape. And this is called a sporangium. And this inside the sporangium, you got so many spores, so many nucleus with so many spores will be produced. And when this sporangium break, it will be dispersed and it will spread to other places. It can be easily carried away to other places through the wind. These are called spores. And this is the type of reproduction you studied last year in class 10, you studied under biology. So Rhizopus, this is asexual reproduction. And second one, sexual reproduction also is there. By the fusion of gamete. So meaning two hypha can fuse together, as I already told you. And the fusion of gamete, sexual reproduction also is possible. And what is called a zygospore is formed. Sexual reproductive, this one, spores. The sexual reproductive structure that is produced because of the fusion of a gamete, and that is called a zygospore. By the fusion of the gamete, you can see zygospore will be produced. zygospore can be produced, zygospore. That is because of sexual reproduction, and it is produced inside the inside, not coming outside, inside the place where they are living. And after the formation of the zygote, again meiosis will takes place. This also is a parasite, albugo. This is coming under this group. Albugo is a fungus coming under this group, and they cause diseases on mustard. Kadugu jeedide ilayilokke poop pole undagunnadana. That disease is a parasite, albugo, parasitic fungus, and it produce, it causes diseases. So many of the fungi can be parasitic, and they are causing diseases in plants. Animal diseases are also there. Now next group is Ascomycetes. Next group, second one is Ascomycetes. In Ascomycetes, what are the characteristics of Ascomycetes? The best example is some edible fungi are there, and then Penicillium and yeast, they are coming under this group. Penicillium, now you are not very familiar. Yeast, which grow by multiply by budding, they are also coming under this example as Ascomycetes. And this Ascomycetes, it is multicellular, meaning they have walls, multicellular. Yeast, you can see, is a unicellular one. It is a multicellular, and also saprophytic or parasitic. It can be saprophytic, feed on dead decaying material. Parasitic means living on other plants and animals and get food. It can be parasitic. Even some of them can grow on dung, cow dung. And if they grow on cow dung, it is called caprophyllus, meaning growing on dung. Chaganathe valarunna type, that is a Caprophyllus. And it is branched and septate. I already told it is a branched hypha, and also septate, not a tubular. Branched means branches are there, and also septate, cross walls are there. These are the cross walls, and they are septate branch. And the sexual reproduction is by producing conidiophores. It is produced outside. So for example, if they are living inside some substance, you can see they will produce outside the substance where they are living. This is the place they are living, inside cow dung or anything. And you can see it will produce hypha outside, and this hypha will be branched. And at the end, you can see like a sporangium, some spores, some sacs are produced like this. It will be produced like this. And each one can cut off, and it will become a new, it can spread into other places. And so this is the SSL reproductive structure. And this structure is called the conidiophore. This is called the conidiophore. And this structure, this is called the conidia. So they reproduce by using conidia. That is a sexual method of reproduction. And sexual method is also there. And sexual method of reproduction is called Ascocarp. And it will not be outside, it will not be growing outside. This is called a sexual reproductive product is called Ascocarp. So that is why it is coming under Ascomycetes, because sexual reproductive structure is called Ascocarp. And asexual reproductive structure also is here. Next group is Basidiomycetes. Third group of fungi, Basidiomycetes. So Basidiomycetes fungi, and the common type is mushroom. Our mushroom is a very good example. Mushroom means nammal uveyikkunna koona. So mushroom, bracket fungi. I have broad bracket fungi. Bracket fungi is like this. Decay in if you examine a decaying wood, something white, something like a bracket. I already brought it and kept in the bag. And this white structure on decaying wood is called bracket fungi. Is also coming under this Basidiomycetes. Next class I will show that one. And mushroom, which is very common, and that also is coming under this group. Some of them are parasitic. They can cause diseases. For rust, rust means a leaf will become damaged. About especially during this season, rainy season, rubber and all that, engane vattathil vattathil povuna penne decompose cheythu povunadana. That is actually because of fungal attack. This is a fungal attack. In olden days, copper sulfate was sprayed. Nowadays, it is not common. And so that is also that kind of disease is called rust. It is affecting so many different type of plants. The septa, the mycelium, as I told you, it is branched and septate. Branch, so many branches will be there, and septate, septum will be also there. Septate, meaning cross walls are there, and then septate. And asexual reproduction is absent. In this one, there is no asexual reproduction. Only sexual reproduction is present. And two hyphae fuse, and a fruiting body, as I already explained, two hyphae will fuse and a fruiting body. Fruiting body means the sexual reproductive product is called fruiting body. Nammal kadikina koona alle mushroom that we see outside, that is a fruiting body, reproductive structure, like a seed or a fruit in a higher organism. That is a reproductive structure in a mushroom. Appo adinu parayna perana fruiting body. That term is used in the text too. Fruiting body means sexual reproductive structure, that is called a fruiting body, is produced. And actually there is a dikaryon phase is there. Dikaryon phase, I told you, two nucleus will stay together for some time. Then after only they will fuse. Dikaryon phase is there, and after the sexual reproduction, you can see the sexual reproductive structure is called basidia, and it is produced, and so many basidia will be arranged into a fruiting bodies, as we know in a mushroom. And this mushroom, that part which come out, this is a mushroom. This is a fruiting body, and it is called a basidiocarp. In parayna vere basidiocarp in science, and that is a reproductive structure or fruiting body in Basidiomycetes. And the last type is Deuteromycetes, last fungi group. Deuteromycetes. Fourth type of fungi, and this is imperfect fungi. Because why it is known as imperfect fungi? Because only asexual stage is found. Sexual stages are not discovered so far. So it is called Deuteromycetes, asexual fungi, and asexual structure is called conidia. They produce conidia, that is the asexual reproductive structure. And some of them are saprophyte, living on dead decaying material. Some are parasite. Some are decomposed. Many are decomposed, and it help in nutrient recycling. Nutrient recycling, you know, area after decomposition, then nitrate and other phosphate, everything will be produced. It will be reabsorbed by again plants. So recycling of nutrients. Ringworms, human attack in the disease and a ringworm, and that ringworm is also is caused by this Deuteromycetes here. But after the discovery, actually they are imperfect fungi. But when the sexual stage is not found, but a sexual stage contributed kanjal, and it can be transferred to other group like Basidiomycetes, Phycomycetes, to transfer, and possibilities there. So that these are the four different type of fungi, four different groups of fungi which already. Okay, we will discuss the answer some questions tomorrow. Okay, wish you all the best.